Ronald Susilo shared with us the highlights of his 12-year professional career. The former world number six continues his story here about life after retirement.
I retired after the Beijing Olympic 2008, right? No, the drive of playing is no longer there, so yeah. So that's why I decided maybe I should just retire. 2015 SEA Games was going to be held in Singapore. I never, play SEA Games in my own country. So suddenly, it's just the feelings come back again. Came back to me that I want to play. Maybe I should try. After about 3 months, I think I start to feel pain in my groin area. So I went to MRI. Then the MRI shows that I have a muscle tear in the groin. I say again, oh God, I feel to me that I am wasting my 3 months of playing a little there, here and there. Then I decided, okay lah, maybe I shouldn't really play anymore, I said. I do enjoy my role now as a coach. The good part is that I don't need to train anymore, don't need to be so tired, do running and everything. Now it's just like, planning the program, sometimes I give drills and everything. It's not as tiring as, when you're being a player, I would say, yeah. Or when you handle a lot of small kids, it's totally different, You need a lot of patience. You need to keep telling them again and again. So sometimes enjoyment can also become, a torture to you. Yeah. But of course, this is, my role as a coach.
I think he is very dedicated as a coach, and he always has our best interests at heart. Like, he always gives specialised training programmes catered to singles and doubles players, which I think are very helpful to our growth as a player. It's a great honour to have him as our coach, as he was the 2004 champion in Japan Open, and it's rare having a Super Series champion as our coach.
Family is, of course, the happiest. This moment in your life when you have a family. I have a complete family, I have a good supportive wife. She has her own career as well. I have two children, boy and girl. I would say I have a complete family. And I love being with my family, being close to them. I always try to, send them, send my two kids and my wife to school and office respectively in the morning. Then after that is my rest time. Then my working hours start in the afternoon. By the time I come back, most probably my two children have fallen asleep. During the weekends, Saturday, I still have to coach. But of course, in the morning, I accompany my daughter to class and everything. So I still have time for them, at least. After my coaching in the evening, then I will totally spend my time with Natalie. We always go out and everything, having a good time and enjoy myself. I would like to be remembered as a player who has the drive, the tenacity, to excel. I don't want them to just think about, remember me as, my achievements, whether I win or lose or this. But I want them to remember about, the journey going through that, achieving my dreams, the ups and downs. And I want them to know that even at the hardest environment or the toughest environment, you still can make something out of it. Yeah, and you still can, succeed if you believe in yourself. That's what I want them to remember me. Yeah.